introduce one culture to another culture. That 300 years, doesn't know what's happening in 5,000, read in the book. But but I was with Gandhi in India. I challenging the people. I found it, what is it, true or not true. The key, if we say, you know what, there's nothing wrong to testify we did wrong. I'm talking about myself. And also it's an opportunity. You see, my God, when I'm not doing wrong and I'm doing good, and I'm doing higher than ever, more than any drug, more than any alcoholic. And this is America. God bless. The 300, you are the man. Remember when we went to the convention center, talking Mr. Cellini, peace, peace. I'm so glad you called. I'm in Chicago right now with Mr. Rocky Jones. We have great movement of the DJ, house of music. And this man, I'm so blessed, after many, many years, we are right now, we have a DJ International Boulevard, and they honor me the piece of the DJ International Award, which is what I put in my heart, and this will be continued along with other recognition of different DJ from all over the world. Once a year, they give the piece for the people who understand the house music is a foundation every art.
Never change the dream. Stay for that. I've been 25 years working so hard when the Dick Clark production signed, said, Mr. Cellini, is it time to do the Family Film Award in CBS? The first time in history I did it. Why the people, the music, international language, they inspire me. Be proud of yourself. I've been many years, I know Mr. Rocky Jones. When I came here to play the acting and I saw his mountain jerseys, try to inspire other young people, and I said, as a friend, what I can provide with this beautiful, great city, Chicago, and the DJ International. Finally, my dream at the United Nations, June 20, this year, is come true, and we, for the first time in history, we have an Olympic of Art. And I brought my part for, give my part for Mrs. Rocky Jones and invite him to DJ International recognition at the United Nations. I did it from my heart, and congratulations to all of them and my dear friend Rocky Jones.
Just to let you know what that means, the United Nations, that is the consciousness of the world. And what we're doing with DJ International, we're going to be one of the groups that present awards to the worthy artists. And so, aside from the arts, I want to present a peace award to Antonio from DJ International, as he deserves it.
Oh, Chicago, I love you. It's too much responsibility for me, from my heart. This is too much. This is going to be in my heart. And you have my word, I have Mr. DJ International in my heart. All of you, is all about the new people. Focusing with this man who bring me here, and I do everything for DJ International all over the world. Thank you for this beautiful one.
2013 in Chicago, Illinois, to Mr. Rocky Jones. Give it up. Give it up for Rocky Jones, y'all. DJ International in the house. Chicago is the only place that can make house music. The only place. A lot of cities want to lay claim to it. A lot of countries want to lay claim to it. But Chicago is the place. In fact, Chicago is the only place in the world that not only gave us house music, they gave us Obama. And not let anybody take that away from you. Whether you want to call it EDM, or you might have called whatever. It is how serious you can always go there. That's all I'm saying. One more time. Big Bay International, Rocky Jones.
Myself.
I am in front of the warehouse. This is where we used to jack our bodies down.
Yo, this is White Knight and you're watching DJ International TV. Hip house rules the world, baby. Don't get it twisted.
So this is Kim Mazzell and I'm in front of the spot where house music started. See the building there? That's the old DJ International.
That's 727 West Randolph.
That's 727 West Randolph. I was an intern there, and I did all the PR for the artist.
The first lady of house music.
The first lady of house music. Well, that's because I got the first international label deal.
That's
but
true.
Also, that true? So that's the building there. And my university, at the time I was at Columbia, and I went and picked to do an internship for this exciting new record label called DJ International. So I went to help to do PR. The next thing you know, I was secretary on the phone. And the next thing you know, some artists needed a PA to go on the road. So Mr. Rocky Jones sent me on the road with Daryl Pandy, Sean Christopher, and Lolita Holloway.
Wow.
I was their slave. This ain't worth my butt to them.
Fingers ink as well.
It's still some that old you can see.
I don't know what he meant by that.
Go hit him, go hit him.
Hey, but you know what? One thing.
I'll be quiet.
Hey, that building is history, though. That's why that could happen.
Yeah, that is a history.
It's all right, Fast Eddie, Tyree Cooper, Ruby Jumper Ray,
yeah, everybody. Gotta have house music.
Oh, Chase My Love. Hey, I'm gonna tell you something about Chase My Love. I was, I think.
You was in the house when Marshall was making the beats.
Making that, my boy Dino came up, played the bass live.
When
did you start working with Mick Jagger?
I started working with Mick Jagger in 1992.
Oh, that is awesome. Right, and what was the song that you guys worked on?
The song that me and Mick Jagger worked on was,
Dig It.
Oh, gosh.
Hey.
When did you start working with Jocelyn Brown? You told me you did a couple of
times. Jocelyn and I were put together by Simon Cowell.
Okay.
And that was 95, okay. I think.
So you know the famous Simon Cowell?
Yes, I know Simon.
And Simon Cowell, was he as brutal with you as the people he was?
Yes. He's good,
so who was Simon working with at that time?
BMG Records.
BMG, okay. And this is out of London, right?
This is in New England.
Okay, right.
We're in Newcastle, drove up today from London, we're at the biggest club in the UK, voted the 12th best club in the world. This is digital. This is